So welcome to Java programming course. So till now we are discussing about in the unit 1 the topics are introduction to object oriented programming system, the next one is the difference between POP versus OOP, the next concept is principles of object oriented programming system, the next one is history of Java, the next Java features. Now today's session I am going to explain about JVM architecture. This is very important. Okay, so this is the heart of entire Java programming language. So let's go to the topic JVM architecture. Before going to explain about this architecture, I want to explain about the procedure of how the Java programming is executed. For example, here takes Java source code, or source file as .java. Okay, this is my file. I am developing one application. Extension is .java. Whereas in C, we are using extension .c. For Java, we are using extension .java. So I am giving it to what? Java compiler. So Java compiler compiles this .java file and convert into what? Bytecode. Also we call as .class file. Also we called as bytecode. This is very important. This bytecode. This bytecode or dot class file, we are giving it to what? In the previous session, we are discussing about the what? Different platforms. What are the different platforms? Here, Windows, Mac OS, Linux. Here, we should have what? JVM. Here also, we should have JVM. This dot class file, we can run on any one of the platform. Maybe Windows, maybe Mac, maybe Linux, irrespective of the operating system. So now we are giving this dot class file to JVM. So what is the internal JVM will do this particular dot class file? So that working processor I am going to explain in this session. So that is the meaning of JVM architecture. So what is the internal process of this JVM process? So after taking this dot class file. So let's go for the particular procedure. So this is the architecture of JVM architecture, JVM machine, means Java virtual machine architecture. This entire architecture means here the input is one. Just now we are discussing about the particular input. What is the input here? The input is dot class file. Just now we have seen, right? Dot class file, also we called as bytecode. So this dot class file and bytecode have taken by what? JVM, Java virtual machine. So JVM internally do the all this process and give the output to the user. So what is the procedure of entire JVM? This entire JVM is divided into three parts. Those are class loader subsystem. This is the part one. The next one is memory area. This is part two. The next one is execution engine. This is part three. These are the three steps internally JVM will do the dot class file into executed file. So let's see one by one. What is the first one? Class loader subsystem. First one is what? Class loader subsystem. In this class loader subsystem is responsible for three activities. Those are, the first one is loading. Next one is linking. The next one is initialization. So class loader subsystem will take the what? Dot class file. This dot class file is received by the class loader subsystem. It will do the three activities. The first one is loading. Second one, linking. Third one, initialization. Let's see one by one, what is the meaning of loading, linking, initialization? What is the first one? Loading. So loading is done by loader. Here we have three loaders. Those are, the first one, bootstrap class loader. The second one, extension class loader. Third one is application class loader. Yeah, these are the three class loaders. With the help of this three class loaders working as what? Loading the dot class file into memory. So the class loaders are, with the help of these class loaders, the loading is done from the dot class file is loaded into the memory area. So that is the purpose of loading. What is the meaning of loading here? These three loaders means anyone can execute, maybe bootstrap loader, extension loader, application loader. So what is the meaning of first one? Bootstrap loader. It is used to load the dot class file from the bootstrap class path into memory area. So that is the purpose of bootstrap loader. So what is the meaning of extension loader? It is used to, like .exe files, right? .ext extension. It is used to load the .ext files into the memory area. So what is the meaning of here application here? Application class loader, it is used to load the application class files into the memory area. So that is the main, that is the purpose of this, all the three loaders. So simply the loading is what here? Loading is done by the loaders. Here we have three loaders. What is the first one? Bootstrap class loader. Second one is extension class loader. Third one is applications class loader. So what is the purpose of this, all the these three loaders? These are used to load the dot class file into memory area. So that is the meaning of this loading concept. The second one is what? Linking. So after loading, we have to verify. Verification is we have to do. This verification is done by verifier. This is very, very important. That verifier also we called as bytecode verifier. And when we are going for any interview, they may ask, what is the meaning of bytecode verifier? Means during the linking process, verification is done by verifier. What is the meaning of verifier here? Verification. Our dot class file is in the format or not. And also, our dot class file is generated by compile, exact compiler or not. And also, this linking process is also done by this dot class file is in the format or not. And also, it will check the our code is error free or not, means virus free or not. That is done by linking, means verification. So the verification is done by the what? In the phase of linking process. The next, in the linking process, one more approach is preparation. Preparation. So what is the meaning of preparation? With the help of preparation, it will allocate the memory to the our local variables. Whatever the variables we are declared in the in our program means local variables. For that variables, memory is allocated during the preparation stage. Where the preparation stage is inside the linking phase. So inside the linking phase, we have what? First one, verification. Second one, preparation. The third one is what? Resolution. Resolution. So in the linking process, first one is verification. What is the meaning of verification? It checks our dot class file is in the format or not. And also it will checks it is error free or not. That is the reason Java is secured. What is the reason? Because of this verification. Who done this verification? Verifier. This verifier also we called as bytecode verifier. Very, very important that point. The next one is what? In the linking phase, preparation. What is the meaning of preparation? It will allocate the memory to the particular local variables. Whatever the variables we had declared in the program, for that variables, memory is allocated, right? With the help of preparation. What is the next one here? Resolution. What is the meaning of resolution? It simply allocated the symbols, symbolic representation. Symbols. It simply allocates the symbols, whatever symbols we are using in our program. So that is the purpose of what? Resolution. So till now we discussed about the what? Within the class loader subsystem, we have three responsibilities. First one is loading, second one linking. So last one is what? Initialization. The simple meaning, what is the meaning of initialization? It will allocate the what? Default values to our variables. Best example, pi value 3.1415, right? Like this, whatever the variables we are declared, like static variables. For static variables, it allocates default values. So clear, right? This is the meaning of class loader subsystem. So till now we discussed about the what? Only the part one of JVM architecture. Next we go for second part. What is second part? This part we call as what? Second part we call as what? Memory area. Memory area. This entire memory area, why we require this memory area? With the help of class loader subsystem, it loads the dot class file. After loading, we have to place some area, right? We require some area. Why? Because for storing our dot class file. So for that purpose, we required memory area. Memory area mainly used for what? For storing our dot class file. Okay. So in this memory area is divided into five parts. Those are method area, heap area, Java stacks, PC registers, native method stacks. Let's see one by one. Very, very important. First one is method area. Method area stores all the class level data. All the class level data. What about heap area? Heap area stores all the objects. Whatever the objects are initiated, those objects are stored in the heap area. What is the next one? Java stacks. This is very, very important. Java stacks here, for example, it creates a runtime stack for every thread. A runtime stack for every thread. So this is we call as what? Threads, right? T1 thread for runtime, one individual stack. T2 thread, individual stack, T3 thread, individual stack. So what is the purpose of stack area? It will allocate the runtime stack for individual thread, whatever thread those are created. What is the next one? PC register. What is the meaning of PC register? PC means program counter. So what is the purpose of PC register? It will also allocate the program counter for each thread. So what is the meaning of PC register? For irrespective of each thread, one PC register is allocated for each thread. With the help of PC register, it tells about the current execution of a thread. It tells about the what? Current execution of a thread address. It also gives the which instruction is executed next. That is the meaning of PC register. What is the next one? Native method stack. What is the purpose of native method stacks? It also gives about the for each thread, it stores native method information. That is the meaning of native method stack. It is used to what? Maintain native method information for each thread. So this is the meaning of what? Memory area. So entire memory area is divided into 5 parts. What are the first one? Method area is mainly for class level data. What about next one? Heap area. The whatever the objects are initiated or declared during our program, those objects are stored in the heap area. What are the next one? Java stacks. It stores the for each thread individual runtime stack is created for each thread, like this example. Okay, what is the next one? PC register. What is the meaning of PC register? Program counter. It gives about the what? Which instruction is executed present, and also it gives about the which instruction is executed next. That is the meaning of what? PC register. So PC register for irrespective of all the threads. What is the next one? Native method stack. Native method stack gives the information, native method information for each thread. So this is the meaning of second part is what? Memory area. So this is about the what? Memory area. So memory area contains what? 5 parts. Those are method area, heap area, Java stacks, PC registers, native method stacks. So next we go for what? The third part is we call as execution engine. So till now we are simply what? Loading the dot class file and placed into what? Memory area. After that, till now we are not doing any execution, but now we go for what? Execution of our dot class file with the help of execution engine. So also here, execution engine contains 3 parts. Those are very, very important when we are going for any interview. Those are interpreter. The next one is JIT compiler. The next one is garbage collector. And some more components are also there, but these 3 are very, very important. Okay, first, execution engine takes this dot class file and executes the particular dot class file line by line. This process we call as interpretation. So with the help of interpreter, it executes the dot class file line by line. This process we call as interpretation. So with the help of interpreter, the dot class file is executed by the line by line. The next, if we are using interpreter, it is doing the execution line by line. For example, if you want to call the same method multiple times, the interpreter will do the what? Again and again, it will execute the line by line program multiple times. So it will take the more time. In order to sort out this problem, we go for just-in-time compiler. This is very, very important. Why? Because this is also doing the same task, whatever the task done by the interpreter, same task is done by the JIT compiler. The difference is, if you are calling the same method multiple times, The first time it will convert into what? Native code. The second time or third time, multiple times, if you are calling the same method, no need to execute the entire program line by line. Why? Because with the help of native code, we can directly call the particular methods. So that is the meaning of what? Just-in-time compiler. It will improve the performance of the applications. So that is the reason JIT compiler, sometimes execution engine calls the JIT compiler. When we are calling the same method multiple times, we require just-in-time compiler. Otherwise, simply we are using what? Interpreter. Okay. The next one is, one more important component is garbage collector. So what is the meaning of garbage collector? It is used to free the unused objects memory. Unused objects memory. With the help of garbage collector, it is used to what? Whatever the objects those are in the inactive state, those objects memory is freed with the help of what? Garbage collector. This garbage collector called by whom? Internal execution engine we have JVM. This is JVM, right? Enter the process JVM. But here the JVM means what here? garbage collector, JVM calls the garbage collector, just in time compiler, interpreter. All these tasks are done by the with the help of JVM. So clear, right? So this is about the what? Execution engine. So while we are executing our dot class file, one thing we have to require, those are native method libraries. These libraries are required while we are executing our dot class file line by line with the help of execution engine. Those are native method libraries. So native method libraries contains one the set of libraries which are required for execution of our dot class file. So clear, right? But how these native method libraries are used for the execution engine? With the help of one interface. That interface we called as very important JNI, Java Native Method Interface. So with the help of this interface, the set of libraries which are required for execution of our dot class file with the help of JVM, those are provided with the help of what? JNI, Java Native Interface. So this is about the what? Native Method Interface. So this is entire three parts of JVM architecture. The first one is what? Class loader subsystem. Next one, memory area, also we call as runtime data area. Third part is what? Execution engine. So this is about the what? JVM architecture. Next we go for one by one steps. So here first one is what? Class loader subsystem. The main activities are what? First one, loading. Next one, linking. The next one is what? Initializations. Already we have seen all these steps, right, in the previous slide. So what is the purpose of loading here? Simply it loads the dot class files into what? Memory area. Main memory area here, what? Method area. What is the next one? Linking. What is the purpose of linking here? The three main keywords, what? Verification, preparation, resolution. So what is the meaning of verification? It will verify with the help of verifier. It checks our bytecode or dot class file is in the format or not, or error free or not, with the help of verifier. This verifier also we called as bytecode verifier. Okay, next one is what? Preparation. With the help of preparation, it allocates the memory to the class level variables. What is the next one? Resolution. What is the uses of resolution? It is useful for symbolic data. Symbolic data, okay, symbolic representation of data, we are using resolution. What is the next one here? Last one, initialization in the class loader subsystem. What is the meaning of initialization? It will allocate the default values to the static variable, default values. So this one already we discussed in the previous slide, right? So this is about the what? Class loader subsystem. The next one, what is the next one? Next one is memory area. So till now, just now we discussed about the memory, right? What is the memory area? It consists of 5 parts. Those are what? Method area, heap area, stack area, next one PC registers, the last but one is native method stacks. So what is the purpose of each one? It contains what? Only the class level data. This part contains class level data. What about this part? This part contains objects data. Whatever the objects we are creating, those objects are stored in the heap area. What about this part? This part contains what? For each individual thread, a runtime stack is created. Clear, right? This part contains for each individual thread, a runtime stack is created. One more important keyword is this record we called as active record. Active record. Okay? I think here I noted activation record and active record. Also we called as what? Stack frame. This one. So clear, right? So this entry we called as what? Activation record or active record. Also we called as stack frame. This one. Stack frame, we called as stack frame. In this memory area, next part is what? PC registers. It stores about the what? Current address of, current execution of instruction of the particular thread. Okay, what are the next one? Native method stack. It gives what the what? Native method information of the particular thread. So this is about the memory area. What are the next one? Is last one is execution engine. The three main components of execution engine are what? First one, interpreter. Next one, just-in-time compiler. Next one is garbage collector. What is the meaning of interpreter? Generally, JVM we call as an interpreter. Why? Because it takes the dot class file, execution engine takes the dot class file, it executes the program line by line. So that is the meaning of interpretation. The next one, what here? What are the drawbacks of interpreter? The drawbacks means, if you are calling the same method multiple times, the interpreter do the what? Multiple times it will execute the line by line. That is the main drawback of interpreter. In order to solve this problem, we go for just-in-time compiler. Just-in-time compiler converts into what? First time it converts into native code. So because of this native code, if you are calling the same method multiple times, no need to execute the entire program line by line. So
So that is the purpose of just-in-time compiler. It will improve the performance of the program execution. Okay. The next one is garbage collector. It is used to what? Free the unused objects memory. Okay. Unused objects memory, like as dynamic memory allocation in C we are using, right? Same thing, but here JVM will do all these tasks. No need to write the code. Okay, so garbage collector used to what? Free the unused objects memory. It cleans the unused objects memory. So that is the purpose of garbage collector. What are the next one? So next one is native method interface. So before native method interface, we have what? Native method libraries. It provides the set of libraries which are required for our execution of our program. These libraries are linked to the execution engine with the help of what? Native method interface. With the help of native method interface. So this is about the what? Execution engine part. So our entire JVM architecture contains three parts: class load subsystem, memory area, also we call as runtime memory area. Next one is execution engine. So this is about the JVM architecture. Thank you.